Greetings, dear viewers. Firstly, I want to express my sincere gratitude to each one of you for taking the time to watch my previous video on Tom Willett, also known as FeatureMan. In the vast ocean of YouTube channels, it is truly gratifying to know that my opinions have resonated with some of you. If you appreciate the content I create, I would like to humbly request you to hit the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell to stay updated on my future videos. Moreover, if you find this video informative, don't forget to leave a like to support the channel. Your engagement plays a crucial role in helping me enhance the quality of my content and deliver more value to you. I feel an inherent obligation to make a follow-up video today, given the recent development that has left me astonished. There are still individuals among us who are defending a child predator. While it is true that Tom Willett has received his sentence, he was nonetheless released on a technicality. This fact alone should give us pause for thought. But what is even more concerning is the lack of remorse displayed by Mr. Willett for his actions. He groomed not one, but multiple children. And yet he behaves as though his actions were of little consequence. In fact, he went so far as to lie to the camera, claiming that his initial victim was not 14 years old, but 18. It is truly abysmal that he would seek to deceive us in such a manner. The reality is that the young man in question, who is now a full-grown adult, will be forced to carry the trauma of his abuse for the rest of his life, along with the other victims of FeatureMan's grooming. How can one's moral compass be so distorted as to defend such reprehensible behavior? Even elderly individuals should not receive a golden Willy Wonka ticket, as it were, for past transgressions. If cancel culture can be used to hold YouTubers and coaches accountable for even minor infractions such as slapping someone's butt, then why can't it be used to cancel FeatureMan for grooming children? It is truly mind-boggling. In my previous React video, I responded to Muta, the individual behind Some Ordinary Gamer. A follower of mine on Twitch had recommended that I checked it out, and so I did. At the time, I had never even heard of FeatureMan. However, after giving my opinion, I felt that it would make for good YouTube content. While I consider myself to be primarily a gamer at heart, I also believe in giving my honest opinions on a wide range of topics, from poorly designed games to serious issues. It seems that many people today are unable to handle divergent opinions without resorting to outrage. This is why it is crucial to maintain open lines of communication and to listen respectfully to those with differing viewpoints. To those who would belittle me for my lack of knowledge regarding specific laws or the intricacies of Nevada's legal system, I say this. I did not attend law school, nor am I an expert in every aspect of the law. Nevertheless, my opinion is informed by what I have seen, and I stand by my assessment of FeatureMan's actions as deeply troubling and morally reprehensible. Furthermore, I find it disheartening to witness the speed with which Hollywood actors like Kevin Spacey can be cancelled by the internet and the media based on allegations of sexual misconduct. Yet when it comes to an older individual like FeatureMan who has engaged in egregious and exploitative behavior towards children, there are still those who seek to defend him. They may argue that his actions occurred more than 50 years ago, but I would counter that Kevin Spacey's misconduct took place only 15 years ago, and yet he has been all but exiled from the entertainment industry. His last major role in the film All the Money in the World was even removed after his misconduct came to light. In conclusion, defending a child predator like Tom Willett is simply unacceptable. It is not only harmful to the victims, but it also sends a dangerous message to society. We should not be allowing predators to roam free and continue their harmful behavior, regardless of whether they were caught in a technicality or not. Furthermore, Cancel culture is not about taking away someone's right to free speech or expression. It is about holding people accountable for their actions. If we allow people like Tom Willett to continue to have a platform and to be defended, then we are not doing our part in making sure that justice is served.